Welcome back, guys. So, carrying on from where we left off, so we're going to be in the previous tutorial. We're supposed to create fingers for this guy, but I totally forgot. So, let's create some fingers for this piece. So, to do that, I will need to kind of have a duplicate of this body mesh. So, let's just do duplicate for this. Then I'll just do a quick save. Okay. Let me just rename this to Vijal. So, no, that's VJ. So it'll be like an H in here. Okay, something like this should be fine. Then this one, I'm just going to rename this to fingers. Then I'm going to hide the top one. This top one still comes with all the layers attached to it, I believe. Let's just cross check. And just go to a much higher subdivision level for this. Okay, everything is in there. Let me go to the lower subdivision level and select the fingers for this. Turn off the eyeball, turn this eyeball on. The subdivision level will be on this particular mesh. So the first thing we're going to do is to kind of bake the layers. Layers in here, let's just do a bake all for this. We'll come down to a lower subdivision level, maybe around subdivision level 3 or a bit higher. Now delete lower also. Then let's delete everything else apart from the hands. Yes. So I'll just go to modify topology and then use delete hidden. I'm going to be using the max pen. Yes, it should be the max. Yes. I'm going to use the max pen to kind of map out where the, well, before I kind of do that, I like to kind of use the damn standard brush to kind of map, max, kind of highlights or create a depth where the fingers should be. Okay. Think something around here looks fine. Maybe use the move brush. Kind of move things in place a bit more. Then the standard brush. So I'm still going to use the standard brush to kind of block out where the fingers should more or less be. Okay. I'm kind of zooming out, kind of check if the size is right for this. Okay, that looks fine. Alright, I think this should work just fine. I think we're working on this symmetrically. This should be affecting the other side also. Yeah, that's fine. Okay. Think now I can easily extract or max out where the finger should be, then create some good enough topology for it, kind of old bits. I'm just going to use the pen maxing, kind of max where the finger should be. So let me just carefully mark all of what I will need for this. Maybe even add some extra edges. Because the idea is just to, as soon as I'm done marking this out, I'm just going to create a polygroup out of this. Then I isolate that polygroup and delete the rest of the arm and just leave only the fingers. Okay. Almost done, just making one more piece and we should be done. So I always prefer not to kind of skip the tutorial so that I can actually show you guys precisely what I'm doing without any step being skipped. And for the most part, I don't even really do much editing for the recorded videos because I just want to have everything out raw the way it is. The way I kind of edit is just the sound, so it's much easier for you guys to kind of follow along. But aside that, everything I'm doing is just on the fly without trying to kind of hide some part where some mistakes are being made and then fixing it by myself without showing you guys. So what you guys can observe, and then any mistake I make, you can fix it together. So when you encounter the same error, you can always fix it yourself too. So shift F to go to polyframe. Then Ctrl W to give this a different polygroup. So now I can isolate this polygroup now for the fingers. Okay, so what I'm going to do now is I'm going to do a delete hidden. I think it's best I just focus on the left hand side. Then I can always mirror what is on the left hand side to the right hand side. So let's do delete hidden first. Then I'm going to draw a rectangular selection around this. So keep in mind that you have to go out of symmetry mode here first. So go out of symmetry. Select all of this. Ctrl W to give them a different polygroup. Ctrl click on it again to Ctrl Shift click rather. I'm sure you guys are already familiar with some of these shortcuts, so it shouldn't get lost. Then delete hidden again. Then now I think we can work with just this specifically. So I want to start by going to deformation. Let's do a polish by features first. Okay. This I can adjust just to make it look more, give it a better shape to it. And just polish this with the polish by groups. Okay. This looks just about right. Then we can do a zero match for this. Let's do a zero match for this. So now geometry, let's just go to zero match, and then I'll turn off the adaptive because I don't want the space in between each polyface to kind of adapt based on the curvature of this model. So I want to kind of have equal spacing around the quads in the entire thing. So 5k, I don't know if 5k should be detect crease, detect edge, keep groups, turn off smooth groups, it should be fine. Then zero mesh. Okay. I believe this should be, let's just do half of this again. Yeah, this should be fine. This will work just fine. The little left now just to give you some thickness, so I would, let's make sure everything is the same poly group. Now let's go to edge loop. Polish. Let me take this down. Edge loop. Let's leave this at 2. Let's leave this at 2. So elevation should be on 100 because we want to extrude outward, not downwards. We want to extrude upwards, not downwards. So I think bevel, let's take this down to 0. This should be fine. Let's try. I don't know if the thickness will be enough though, but let's give it a try. Let's see. Now this thickness is way too much, so we need to take this down. This is somewhere around here, seems fine. Okay. This is way too thick. Take it down some more. What does this even do? Panel loops double sided. Let me turn it up, let's see what that does. Oh, okay. That should be on. Yeah, I think this should be fine. This should work. I guess this should work. Let me just increase this loop to something around a value of 4. Yeah, this is even better, so this should be just fine. Okay. So even if I kind of subdivide this, let's just go one subdivision level higher. If you kind of hold, you still kind of hold the shape properly. So let me undo that. Then I would just kind of mirror this to the other side. So modify topology, mirror and weld. Okay, then let's bring, turn this back on. Let's just increase the subdivision level a bit so we can actually see. So we can actually see this properly. Okay. Definitely to do a bit more work in here by pushing and adjusting some of these, but let's just increase the subdivision level a bit more. So around 1 million. Then we can, let me go to the layers, create a new layer in here. And I'll just name these fingers. I'm going to just kind of keep things organized. Then I can use the them standard brush now to kind of carve out where I might isolate this finger. Kind of carve out where this finger should kind of sit on. Okay. Should be fine for now. Maybe while we're here, we can just make it a few more detailed. So I can use the standard brush to kind of create an indentation around it. Just to give it a bit more depth. Okay. Now select the finger itself. Okay, let's just use, oh, we don't need to do that. We don't need to do that. So let me just use the move brush instead with a bigger size to it. Kind of move this in place. Just take down the size a bit more. Okay. Something like this would be just fine. Yeah, this will work just fine. There's no need to be extremely and overly complicated. Maybe I can just raise this out a bit more, like so. Doesn't need to be completely perfect, just need to have something in there. Something like this from a distance should work. Alright, so back to the fingers. Let's go to the next one. So let's just isolate this. I believe I'm working symmetrically, yes. I don't think I'm working symmetrically for this piece though. But that's fine, I can always mirror this to the other side, that's completely fine. So, back in here. Okay. The standard brush kind of create an indentation around it. Let's just keep creating an indentation around here. Just to raise this up. Then I can increase the brush size, use the move brush to kind of move this in. Okay. Let's just get this to fit properly. Alright, this should be just fine. Almost there. Alright. On to the next one. Okay. Then with the standard brush, we can elevate these edges a bit more. I think I should turn off this lazy mouse for this. So I can work a bit faster in here. Okay, almost done with this. So let's just select the fingernail instead. The move brush. Let's just move this in. Okay. Just get this in properly like so. We push this back in a bit more around the, no, that's a bit too much. Alright, this should work just fine. I think we have two more to go. So damn standard brush. Create an indentation in there. Okay. Then with the standard brush, let's just inflate that same edge around it. Maybe that's a bit much. Let's smooth this edge. Take down the smooth intensity for this. Okay. Then let's select the finger and then push this in. The move brush. And take down the size of the move brush. And just go on individual edges and then just adjust this a bit more. Maybe doing this. Okay, I mean, I'll just leave the shape like this. That shape looks a bit interesting. Last parts, last piece. Okay. Probably just dig this in a bit more. So this standard brush, we can. No, that's a bit red. Take this down a bit more. Okay. Yeah, something like this should be fine. Not necessarily extend all the way here though. Then with the move brush, we can move this in. Let's take down the size of this brush, the move brush, and just continue adjusting this until it sits. Until this sits right in properly. Okay. Alright, this should be fine. I think it should work just fine, okay? Yeah, this should be fine, more or less. Doesn't need to be extremely detailed, just need to give an impression of it being there. No, it's not as clear as we would like it to be in here, but something like this should be fine. Then I'm just going to mirror this to the other side again. So I'll go to geometry, we just take this from the other side. You can see how some of this is a bit out. So let's just do mirror and wedge. Okay. That should fix everything. Let's just do a quick save for this file. Okay, that's fine. So now in the next lesson, we're going to be taking a closer look at the head. I'm trying to make it similar to the likeness of this. So I'll see you guys in the next lesson.